Very good morning, children. Let us start with our first chapter from 12th standard, that is mathematical logic. Now, if I talk about the word logic, you are very familiar with the word logic. How? Because every day we give certain reasons, certain excuses, certain explanations, certain proofs. All these requires one thing in common, that is logic. If I give a very current example, like when we tell you to unmute yourself, to speak, you have many nice reasons. My net is not working, my audio is not working. So giving reasons is an art, and that art of reasoning is called as logic. So logic means reason, or it means dealing with the method of reasoning. Okay. So today we'll be learning about mathematical logic. So to learn mathematical logic, first you should understand what is meant by a sentence and what do you mean by a statement. Now if I go flashback with your English, you have learned various type of sentences. The very simplest sentence was assertive sentence. Then you had interrogative sentence, exclamatory sentence, then imperative sentence, correct? These were the four type of sentences you had learnt in English. Okay, so when I talk about sentences, interrogative, exclamatory and imperative sentences are not statements. They are not statements. The sentences which include question mark, exclamation, or their request, order, such type of sentences are not statement. So exactly what do you mean by a statement? A statement is a assertive sentence. An assertive sentence which is either true, means it should be assertive sentence, as well as either it should be true or it should be false. But never both. Then that sentence is called as a statement. An assertive sentence which is either true or false but never both is a statement. Example, I can say sun rises in the east. 5 into 2 is equal to 11. 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. All these are statements. We'll look after it whether they are true or false later on, but all these assertive sentences are statements. Understood? One more we have now, this, that is open sentence. Let us understand what do you mean by open sentence. Like if I write a mathematical expression like x plus 3 is equal to 5. I cannot say that this statement, this sentence is true or false until I get to know the value of x. Jab tak x malum nahi padega, I can't tell the truth value of this statement. You need to solve this, that x2 aayega. But right now, we don't know the value of x. The value of x is unknown. Hence, this is an open statement. An open statement are not this is an open sentence. And open sentences are not statement. Okay, this is open because x is unknown to me. Like if I say he is handsome, now again I can't say the truth value till I come to know who is that he. Jab tak us he ke bare mein pata nahi chalega, I can't tell the truth value of this sentence. So it is no more a statement, it is an open sentence. Okay, now in logic all statements are denoted by small letters P, Q, R, S and so on. All statements are denoted by P, Q, R, S and so on. Okay. Now, I can combine these statements in logic. Now, I want to combine the statements in logic. What I want to do? I want to combine statements in logic. There are four ways through which I can combine. One is conjunction, other is disjunction, then we have implication, and lastly we have double implication. ठीक है. Now conjunction means mathematical symbol is and, disjunction means mathematical symbol is or, implication means a single arrow, double implication means double arrow. ठीक है. Now when I talk about conjunction, it means I am combining two statements by the keyword and but. I am combining two statements by the keyword and but. Like I can say 2 + 3 = 5 and mango is a fruit. And mango is a fruit. So what I have done, this statement and this statement I have combined by the word and. So when it comes to and but, it means it is conjunction in logic. It is conjunction in logic. And I can say the symbolic form of this will be P and Q. What can I say? The symbolic form will be P and Q, but this will be P and this will be Q. So I'll say that P is 2 + 3 = 5 and Q is mango is a fruit. What will I say? Mango is a fruit. Then the symbolic form will be P and Q. Now for disjunction, I'll take the same statements, 2 + 3 = 5 or mango is a fruit. I'll connect the two statements by the word or. I'll connect the two statements by the word or. Okay. Then we have implication. Implication means if a certain statement, then a certain statement. Like here I can write if 2 + 3 = 5, then mango is a fruit. Then mango is a fruit. What can I say? If 2 + 3 = 5, then mango is a fruit. Okay. Also, I'm writing the symbolic form. Now, double implication. Double implication means P double implies Q. Now, P double implies Q का मतलब होता है combining the two statements like this. A statement if and only if another statement. Statement if and only if another statement. Like I can say 2 + 3 = 5 if and only if mango is a fruit. If and only if mango is a fruit. Getting it? 2 + 3 = 5 if and only if mango is a fruit. So in mathematical logic, statements can be combined in four ways: and, or, if then, if and only if. And states for conjunction, or states for disjunction. Then if then indicates implication or conditional, and double if means double implication. Okay, double if means double implication. Okay. Now since we have learned the combination of statements, I want to learn when can I say that the combined statement is true or false. Like I have two statements PQ and I want to say what happens when they are combined. Will the final answer be true or will the final answer be false? Okay. So whenever I talk about stating the truth value, if I have two statements P and Q, then P can be true two times, P can be false two times. It is same like tossing coins. Then Q will be true, false, true, false. Please maintain this sequence. Then you have two statements P and Q. Okay. Now in the case of and. Now and means both the conditions must be satisfied. Like in Diwali we say na, mujhe ye bhi chahiye, mujhe wo bhi chahiye. When we demand, we have the condition and. I want both the things and I'll be happy if I get both the things. Similarly, the and combination is true if both the statements are true. Like the first part, true and true will be true. Rest, everything will be false. And mein ek bhi statement false aaya, to the final answer becomes false. Okay. Then or. If you talk from a parent's side, what the parent says, either take this or take this, you'll not get both. So what we do, chalo, let us get at least one thing, we'll be happy. So in the case of or, ek bhi statement true hai, toh answer is true. It is false only when both are false. It is false only when both are false. Implies mein, it is if something, then something. Toh agar P true hai, तो Q false हो ही नहीं सकता. अगर P true है तो Q should never be false. So if both are true, it is true. True false आएगा false, then true true. So implies में only true implies false is false. Implies में true implies false is false. Okay. Double implies में true implies true, double implies true, true आएगा. If both are same, it is true. Otherwise it is false. If both are same, it is true, otherwise it is false. Okay, we'll use this. This is called as truth values of the combined statement. Truth values of the combined statement. This you have to learn nicely. This you have to learn nicely. Only then you will understand how to write the truth value. Okay, now let us go with the exercise and solve the sums of whatever topic we have learned right now. So it is five. State which of the following are statements justify in case of statement state its truth value. Now see, 5 + 4 = 13, it is an assertive sentence, so it is a statement and it is a false statement. So we'll write it is a statement and answer is false because 5 + 4 = 13 नहीं होता है. Okay, so my statement है तो I'll put a tick mark and I'll write the truth value of that statement. In exam you'll write it is a statement or it is not a statement. Second, x - 3 = 14, it is not a statement because I don't know what is x. It is not a statement because I don't know what is x. Close the door, it is a request, it is no more a statement. 0 is a complex number. Statement hai and it is true. 0 is a complex number and it is a statement. Please get me breakfast. Again order hai, not a statement. Congruent triangles are similar. It is a statement and we know that congruent is equivalent to similar. So it is true. x² = x, again x is unknown, it is not a statement, it is an open sentence. A quadratic equation cannot have more than two roots. Yes, it is a statement and very true, it cannot have more than two roots. Do you like mathematics? It is an order, a question, not a statement. The sun sets in the west, it is a statement. Now you'll write the truth value of this statement on your own. All real numbers are whole numbers, it is a statement. The remaining I'm solving directly, you will solve on your own the truth value. Okay, tick mark means a statement, so sums I've left the truth values missing, that you will write on your own. Okay, is it clear? Next question. Write the following compound statements symbolically. They have written in words, you have to write in symbolically. So whenever the word appears symbolically, first we'll find the individual statements. What is P? What is Q? So here if you see, they are added by the word AND. AND ke pehle wala statement kya hai? P. So I'll write Nagpur is in Maharashtra. Mera P kya aayega? Nagpur is in Maharashtra. What will be my Q? Chennai is in Tamil Nadu. What will be my Q? Chennai is in Tamil Nadu. Now both statements are joined by the word AND. So my symbolic form becomes P and Q. My symbolic form becomes P and Q. Okay? Second, what will be my P again? Triangle is equilateral. Triangle is equilateral. Q kya aayega? ट्राइंगल इज आइसोसलस, है ना। ना बोथ द स्टेटमेंट्स आर एडेड बाई द वर्ड और, सो मेरा सिम्बॉलिक फॉर्म आएगा पी और क्यू। वॉट विल माई सिम्बॉलिक फॉर्म? पी और क्यू। थर्ड वन, द एंगल इज राइट एंगल क्या है मेरा? पी। इट इज मेजर ऑफ 90 डिग्री क्या है मेरा? क्यू। दे बोथ आर कनेक्टेड बाई द वर्ड इफ एंड ओनली इफ, सो मेरा सिम्बॉलिक फॉर्म क्या आएगा? पी डबल इम्प्लाइज क्यू, पी डबल इम्प्लाइज क्यू। ओके ओके, नाउ वन थिंग आई फॉरगॉट टू एक्सप्लेन यू, द वर्ड निगेशन। निगेशन का मतलब होता है, या आई विल से द वर्ड नॉट। नॉट, वेर एवर यू सी नॉट, यू विल अप्लाई द सिम्बॉल लाइक दिस। इन लॉजिक नॉट मीन्स अ सिमिलर साइन, लाइक इन द एग्जाम्पल फोर हम नेगेटिविटी नहीं लाएंगे, तो मेरा पी क्या लेंगे? एंगल इज एक्यूट। क्या लिखूंगा पी को मैं? एंगल इज एक्यूट। और क्यू आई विल राइट एंगल इज ऑब्ट्यूज। व्हाट विल आई राइट फॉर क्यू? एंगल इज ऑब्ट्यूज। बट यहाँ पर वर्ड क्या है? नाइदर। नाइदर का मतलब क्या होता है? नॉट। सो सिम्बॉलिकली ये हो जाएगा निगेशन पी। आई हैव सेड पी एंगल इज क्यू एक्यूट एंड दे आर सेइंग नाइदर, सो नाइदर मीन्स निगेशन। नॉर का मतलब होता है नॉट प्लस एंड। नॉर मीन्स नॉट प्लस एंड। सो एंड का ये हो गया नॉट मतलब निगेशन। इट इज नॉट ऑब्ट्यूज, सो निगेशन पी एंड निगेशन क्यू। और आई विल से नॉट पी एंड नॉट क्यू। व्हाट विल आई से? नॉट पी एंड नॉट क्यू। ओके, नेक्स्ट, ये मेरा पी हो गया, ये मेरा क्यू हो गया। सो इट इज इफ एंड देन, सो माय सिंबॉलिक फॉर्म विल बी पी इम्प्लाइज क्यू। क्या आएगा मेरा सिंबॉलिक फॉर्म? पी इम्प्लाइज क्यू। हिमा विंस गोल्ड मेडल पी, शी रन्स फास्ट क्यू। दे आर कनेक्टेड बाय इफ एंड ओनली इफ, सो डबल इम्प्लीकेशन, करेक्ट। अगेन यहाँ पर सेवेंथ में मैं पी क्या लिखूंगा? एक्स इज इरेशनल, है ना। आई विल राइट पी एज एक्स इज इरेशनल। तो ये क्या हो जाएगा? निगेशन पी, बिकॉज नॉट है। स्क्वायर ऑफ एन इंटीजर स्टेटमेंट क्यू है। दे आर कनेक्टेड बाय बट, सो आंसर क्या आएगा? निगेशन पी एंड क्यू। क्या आंसर आएगा? निगेशन पी एंड क्यू। ओके, थैंक यू।